Lok Sabha just days away. Big political row has now erupted over the promises that's been made by the CPIM as part of their poll manifesto. CPIM has promised to eliminate all nuclear weapons if voted to power. In its manifesto, the CPIM vowed to eliminate mass destruction weapons, be it chemical or biological. Prime Minister Modi has lashed out at that poll manifesto. He says that the India bloc members were making dangerous poll promises, adding that both India's neighbors are nuclear armed at the moment. This is only going to make India weak, and that the opposition is trying to make India a powerless country.
उन्होंने अपने मैनिफेस्टो में लिखा है, जिस पोखरण की धरती ने भारत को परमाणु शक्ति से संपन्न किया, अब इंडिया अलायंस का कहना है कि हम भारत के परमाणु हथियार नष्ट कर देंगे, दरिया में डुबो देंगे। मैं जरा कांग्रेस को पूछना चाहता हूं, आपके ये साथी या आपके इंडिया अलायंस के साथी किसके इशारे पर काम कर रहे हैं? ये कैसा गठबंधन है जो भारत को शक्तिहीन करना चाहता है? आखिर किसके दबाव में आपका ये गठबंधन हमारे परमाणु ताकत को समाप्त करना चाहता है?
ये लोग पहले ही चाइना रशिया के इशारे पर काम करते थे, ये देश की बर्बादी का हमेशा से जाल बुनते रहे हैं। 1962 की जंग हो या पुरानी बातें हो, इनका इतिहास रहा है सीपीएम का, देश के खिलाफ एंटी नेशनल जो गतिविधियां इनके द्वारा हुई हैं। इस प्रकार के लोगों को इलेक्शन कमीशन को कहीं ना कहीं रोकना जरूरी है, नहीं तो ये देश के लिए घातक सिद्ध होंगे।
As regards this CPM manifesto is concerned, our party will take a view and that will make us abide by that.
हमारे पड़ोस में अगर लोगों के पास एटम बम है तो हम कभी नहीं ये कर सकते।
तो आप समर्थन नहीं करते ऐसी?
नहीं, ये करना ही नहीं चाहिए इन लोगों, कोई नहीं कर सकता है, कहीं नहीं कर सकता है। जो प्रैक्टिकल नहीं है, अब लोग कहते हैं थ्योरेटिकल है,
उन्होंने बकायदा घोषणा पत्र में अपने
तो लिख रहा होगा, तो पूछा जाएगा क्यों लिखा है, हाउ कैन यू डू इट।
21वीं सदी में भारत एक न केवल महत्वपूर्ण आर्थिक शक्ति के तौर पर उभर रहा है, दक्षिण पूर्व एशिया में जो भारत की हैसियत है काफी तेजी से बदली है, और ऐसे में इस तरह के बयानों से निसंदेह दुनिया के अनेक मुल्कों की बाछें तो खिल सकती हैं, लेकिन हिंदुस्तान के लिए ऐसे बयान बड़े खतरे का आह्वान करते हैं।
सीपीएम ने अपने घोषणा पत्र में, हमें लगता है उन्होंने ये कहा होगा, क्योंकि ये देश शांति का संदेश देने वाला देश रहा है, ये गांधी का देश है, ये बुद्ध की धरती है, तो हम तो शांति सद्भाव सद्भावना में विश्वास करते हैं देशवासी, तो उनका कहने का मतलब दूसरा रहा होगा। लेकिन प्रधानमंत्री जी ऐसे ही बातों पर जोर ज़्यादा देते हैं, वनस्पत भूखमरी, बेरोजगारी, पढ़ाई, दवाई, शिक्षा, स्वास्थ्य, जो रोजमर्रे के जिंदगी के आम लोगों के काम आने वाले मुद्दे हैं उस पर बात ही नहीं करते।
Right, let me cut across to Ashutosh Mishra joining us live for more on that. Ashutosh, the CPIM's manifesto where it promises to end all nuclear weapons, chemical or biological, when at a time you have India's two neighbors, be it China, Pakistan, United States, United Kingdom, Russia, almost most of the powerful countries, they're boasting of nuclear weapons. A pointer there that it will finish off nuclear weapons in India if it comes to power there. How has it been received largely? Give us more on the BJP's attacks on the CPIM.
Well, Navila, since late 60s, it was believed that only if you are a nuclear power, you will ensure your sovereignty, your safety, security, and more than the regional peace in your continent or your region. And that was perhaps why every country tried to become a nuclear power, and so was India. As far as left stand on the nuclear issue is concerned, remember, We have already seen the clash between the Congress and the left over the U.S. Nuclear deal, and that was perhaps time when left withdrew its support from the UPA government. So clearly, as far as left is concerned, there always have been idea of India not being a nuclear power or eliminate all the nuclear capabilities that you hold. And that's exactly what is yet again reflecting in their manifesto. As far as BJP is concerned, the BJP is a different pair in this politics. Be it the national security issue or the nationalism issue, the BJP plays its cards in totally different. And in a sharp contrast, when you have an India versus India bloc, and in India bloc where the Congress and left, which have been arch rival during the UPA regime, of the U.S. nuclear deal. In such contrast, when one of the key player, key constituent, CPI-M, making a manifesto, point number 3 on page number 37, literally making that if our government comes, we will eliminate the nuclear power, the biological weapons, and the weapons of mass destruction, it is bound to give BJP an ammunition in a high voltage, high pitch, this election ground, that they will target the entire India bloc. But so far, it was only restricted and limited with the CPI-M. You heard so many opposition parties from the India bloc, none of them have exactly supported. There have been defensive, but they haven't supported the idea. And clearly what manifesto of CPI-M says not necessarily has to be the manifesto of the India bloc if at all they are able to form the government. But in the election campaign, if there are such issues comes, BJP, which is master playing in a different level of politics on such issues, are clearly bound to corner you. And that's what you're seeing. It is reflecting in the Prime Minister's statement of all they are making is already on an almost every election rally.
Well, thanks very much, Ashutosh. You know, right now the bigger question would be, do the India bloc allies really agree with the manifesto put out by the CPI-M? The Congress is one of its ally. In fact, the India bloc collectively have they have different manifesto. They do not have a collective manifesto. But yet, a point as bold as this, where they are going to end nuclear weapons in India if they are voted to power, is something that we've got to see a reaction from the Congress party on that. But thanks, Ashutosh, for joining us.